Hello again, this time I'm making a short video about two topics. First of all, a bit about tail lamps. I want to do a bit more, show some tests, but I need to reorganize some stuff and I've been too busy with the house renovations. So what I will do at now is show a little bit about the Lumi ring, introduced in 2011. I think it was about 2009, 2008 that Busch and Müller introduced the Line Plus, which was the first good LED-based tail lamps. Most LED-based tail lamps were really crappy, but Philips set the bar a lot higher. This is really excellent, and it hasn't been surpassed in, the apparent size and also how little energy it uses to effectively show that there's traffic ahead. It's really good tail lamp. And I wanted to show in a video what you approximately see. So for example, these spots of light at the sides, these are what you really see. They're bright spots and they're the direct light from the LED via the optics. I think it's more or less stray light and not intended, but it's actually quite useful. So the light is pretty good. There have been quite a few tail lamps that are quite good since that time, especially by Spanninga and AXA. Spanninga has taken over the Philips tail lamps and they've introduced the Ellipse, which is a bit less in quality, but it has the same good optics. Quality is lesser in the housing, in the connectors, etc. But it's still recommended. And other tail lamps, for example, that they make, let me show another battery powered tail lamp. Here is the Solo. This is the battery powered Solo. Hasn't got a huge illuminated surface and the huge apparent size, but it's still pretty good tail lamp. As almost all tail lamps these days by AXA and Spanninga are, at least the recent ones, but you can read about that on my site. So what I wanted to do originally was to show a bit about how your vision gets affected by bright tail lamps, especially point sources. And on my site you can read about my criticism of some guy on Candle Power forums who just didn't know what he was talking about. He thought the only issue that affects your vision is glare, internal glare in the eye from light, and that's not true. The second effect that happens is adaptation to the brightest light source. And for example, I was riding about 20-25 meters behind two women. One had a normal tail lamp with good distributing optics, another had a tail lamp with a point source, and I could see absolutely nothing for about half a meter, perhaps a bit more, above, below, just around the tail lamp in all directions. I could not see anything but black, and that's caused by adaptation of the eye to the brightest light source. It was not glare, because I did not see a reddish haze around that area. You can try this effect yourself. If you have a phone with you, put a bit of red tape, for example, for electrics, on the edge of the screen. So for example, if this is the phone, then you could put it here to the side. So this is the screen and you could put it to the side. Then look at it and then switch the phone screen on. What you will then see is that the red tape looks dimmer than originally. And if you switch the screen off again, then the brightness that you will see, for example, can be in daylight or with it depends a bit. I think I tried it in daylight, but perhaps it was in a room with just the lighting from some LED lights on the ceiling. I don't remember exactly. It was quite a few years ago that I tried this, and that showed me this, how much your vision is affected by brightness of the lights, especially very bright if it's very bright in one spot or very bright in total, then the rest becomes dimmer because your eye adapts to it. Okay. Now to another topic. So it's at night and I'm using here a torch to illuminate the remains of my bike trailer. Well, most of it is still okay, but one wheel disintegrated. Oh yeah, that reminds me, another topic I wanted to do, I wanted to show in a night video, was LED light colors. I did some tests on my website and I wanted to add some more. So for example, the SST20, 4000 Kelvin, 95 CRI, color rendition index, lights compared to low CRI. For example, this light that I'm using here, this is torch, is a T64C from Cree, the LED, and I think that's about 4200, 4400 Kelvin, something like that, but with a lower CRI, much lower than the SST20. But the light never arrived after months, so yeah, I still couldn't be I couldn't find a seller of the Lumintop EDC 18 anywhere in Europe, so yeah, still haven't got it. Okay, to the trailer. So I've been using this quite a lot for renovations, to transport stuff, to recycling stones or a leaking radiator, etc. I loaded it quite a bit. I've told you a bit about the problems that I had with this trailer. And I drilled an extra hole into this plate to make it more sturdy, because it broke one time. And you can see how much it has deformed. Yeah, the second bolt just didn't help in that respect. Well, it's quite logical, yeah. Flat plate will bend. This is just a bad design. The whole thing is not very good. For example, see also this rubbing. This is completely gone from, if you put something in it, the wheel will rub against it. They should have made something that's make sure that nothing, this doesn't get pushed out. Okay, but the biggest problem with this trailer is the wheel. So I used it quite a bit, and this is the remains of the hub. These are the spokes, so these are solid spokes. I don't know how many there were in it, but they were welded to the rim and welded to the hub. And I guess it was one of the trips with stones, etc., that I transported. Perhaps a bit too heavy, but you know, you should be able to transport, say, 100 kilograms. Yeah, so if you go sideways with a lot of weight, then there is no deformation possible with these types of spokes. I mean, the wheel probably got damaged a bit, some deformation. I noticed a bit, I thought, yeah, it's not too bad, it's okay. But last week, a bit more than a week ago actually now, I was transporting a few more stones and it was not too heavy, and the defective radiator and some wood, etc., to recycling. And what happened was I heard some ticking noise. I thought, yeah, what's that? Perhaps the radiator? No, it was actually, it seemed okay, but I said, yeah, it has to be the radiator. Then after a bit more riding, I was close to the recycling center, about 3 kilometers away. I took a turn and suddenly the trailer was only riding on one wheel, and this had disintegrated. This is completely toast. You can throw this away. Anyway, yeah, that is one of the bad things. The problem is also that I can't find a replacement. I don't see a replacement part anywhere listed. Perhaps some other manufacturer makes a wheel that mounts on that. But if not, then this trailer is going away, and this is also rubbish. I'm going to remove that. If I'm going to use it again, I'll make some wood enclosure for it. So yeah, that's the update. if you want a bike trailer, don't buy the Roland Traveler. That's just shit. I think any cheap bike trailer from any cheap brand is better than this. It has to be, because this is so crappy. What else? So I've been doing a lot of renovations. This is also why I've not been able to do many of the videos that I wanted to do on various topics, but also my website. I wanted to do some things despite not intending to do so many reviews anymore. But yeah, I couldn't, because I've been working on renovations of the house, and that takes precedence. After that, I don't know what will happen then, because I intend to move to Eastern Europe. I don't really like it here where I live in Western Europe for various reasons. Some of the reasons include the manipulation by the media. Well, you get it in Russia as well, okay, but it's a different type. You know it. Everyone knows it. But a different, there's more of a, how do you call it, a perverted type of manipulation going on of the entire society. But it's been going on since the 80s at least. Well, I could tell you a lot about that, but that's the topic of the projects I'm working on. I've given a few hints. If you're interested, write some comments about it or questions, and I can tell you a bit more with a link to a page where I describe what I'm working on exactly. And it's about explaining everything, just about everything in life, from the different thinking of men and women to manipulation and antisocial behavior, how everything is related and how it causes certain structures in society, etc. Okay, that's a very brief synopsis. I will leave this video for what it is. Until next time.